Hi, hello, I'm Sam Harrison. I read, review and discuss fantasy and science fiction books. Welcome to the Friday Recap Show. This is a weekly video show that goes up every Friday at 5 p.m. in which I talk about the books that I have read this week, the books that I'll be reading next week, and then anything else that I want to talk about, really. So TV and movies, video games, videos that are going up on the channel or that have gone up on the channel and that I want you guys to pay more attention to, which is definitely the case this week. So let's go straight in with the books that I have read and that I have finished. So I read and finished The Silver Blood Promise by James Logan. I used this lovely broken binding edition, which has like incredible artwork in multiple places. I've shown it off before, so I won't spend too long on it. This book I really enjoyed. It didn't give me that like five-star feeling, but it was a book that I still really very much enjoyed. Really good characters, really good world building. I really liked all the magic and mythology aspects of the book. I have not actually recorded my review for this one, which feels like a bit of an oversight because I've now finished it multiple days ago, and I might need to read a recap to be double sure. However, yeah, really enjoyed this one, and really genuinely looking forward to the sequel book, which I believe is going to be announced. Oh no, the cover is going to be shown very soon because the title's already been announced. I can't remember what it is, but I know it's in a new location. And every book in the series is going to be a new location, which is pretty exciting. It's kind of like a road trip book series. So yeah, looking forward to the sequel to this book. This book didn't blow me away in terms of like shattering my expectations of it or anything. It was very much what I expected, but I expected it to be good and it was good. So interesting, really interesting book. Would highly recommend everyone read it. Next up, I read The Martian by Andy Weir. So I've actually finished two books this week and I've started a third, kind of. So I then straight away read The Martian as soon as I finished Silver Blood Promise. I feel like I'm the outlier here, but of the three Andy Weir books that I've read, I actually think Artemis might be my favourite. So I think The Martian's my least favourite. I think the movie was really, really good and maybe a better experience than the book. The thing about the book is a huge chunk of it. Everything from Mars, right? All the Mars stuff with Watney, which is the most exciting stuff, is all epistolary. It's all journal entries that he's posting after the fact. And the problem with that is he can tell you about all these really dangerous things that happened, but you know he survived because he's there to tell you. And like, it takes a lot of the like thrill out of thrilling sequences. So in the movie, you see the things happen in real time and you're like, oh shit, the hab's blown a hole or whatever. Whereas in the book, you're like, oh, I guess he's fine. You know, like it's... I think that it's a good book, but I feel like the format of it takes away a lot of the excitement and the thrill of the content, if that makes sense. It's an odd way for me to talk about this book. We'll do a full review like I do for everything, but my full review for this one is going to be a weird one. I think I ended up giving this a 3 out of 5. I really enjoyed the parts that were on Earth, but guess what? They were in real time. They weren't epistolary. So that kind of makes sense, you know? Moving swiftly on to the final book that I have been reading. And I'm going to do a quick tour of this one because I picked up the broken binding edition of the first binding. I managed to get a copy on Vintage for a really cheap price. And it is literally perfect. Like, it's... everything's here, including the two bookmarks. One says, I know R.R. Verdi, and the other one has a quote from the book. The artwork on the end papers is this kind of, is this candle, which is pretty cool. Same on the back one as well, I think. Yeah, same on the back one. Then if you take off the dust jacket, which is the same as the regular edition dust jacket, because I do actually own the regular edition. I bought that one cheap secondhand because I was intending to read it to catch up for book two, and then I just saw this for such a good price I couldn't say no. However, that has a generic plastic cover, whereas this is cloth bound. This also has a ribbon bookmark, which, as you guys know, I love a ribbon, and it has a really cool quote all the way down the side, which I haven't read because I kind of want to enjoy it when I get to it in the book, if that makes sense, and not be like, oh, this is the famous spine quote. So I haven't read it. It's got black sprayed edges. I have to admit, I'd probably rather it didn't have sprayed edges if it's just going to be jet black, because I don't think that adds anything. Like, the Black Tongue Thief sprayed edges were like block colors on top and bottom, but they continued the cover artwork on the sides, which I thought was really good. And like, I don't know, I would not have paid full price for this from Broken Binding. I have paid full price for the sequel, but it's because I want to get the same number, because, you know, numbered editions, numbered sets. I'm not saying I'm not an idiot. What I am saying is I'm really looking forward to reading this book. I have read, ready? 4 pages. So I started this immediately after finishing The Martian, but it was actually quite late at night and I was like, oh, I'm too tired for this. So I put it down. And then the next day I was on dad duty. So I was hanging out with the new baby all evening so that my wife could have a bit of a break, because, you know, that is a very nice thing to do. And instead of reading on the Kindle, because I do own First Binding on Kindle as well, I got it for 99p quite recently. What I wanted to do was, I was like, I've got this lovely edition, and like, for Artemis and the Martian, I barely read the physical editions. I almost exclusively was listening via the audiobook. So I was like, with this lovely, lovely edition, I actually really want to read it as much as I can from this edition. And I definitely want to start reading from this edition. And I can't hold an 800 page paperback while also holding a 2-month-old baby. So basically, last night was a wash, and I couldn't read it all evening. I'm going to sneak a little bit of reading time today, and I should hopefully be able to read this evening. In an ideal world, I'm going to try and treat this how I treat Wheel of Time books, where I want to get through around 100 pages a day. That's very, very doable for me with Wheel of Time. Many days I've got to 150 or more. But I want to try and do that with First Binding, because it's a really long book. So it is, yeah, it's like, I'm sure it's like 800 pages. Yeah, it's basically 800. So that means that if I want to get through it in a week, I need to be reading more than 100 pages a day, really. But we'll try it 100 pages a day. If it's great, I'll probably read more than that, but that's what I'm going to try and get to. I'm not normally the kind of person who's like, I want to read X amount per day, you know? But I think when I'm reading a big thick book, it actually helps to give myself a target, because then I'm like, all right, I'm going to get through, you know, 3 or 4 chapters, and then that'll be it. Or if you're reading Wheel of Time, you get through the prologue, and that'll be it. And it's a really good way to be like, I'm going to read 100 pages. That's a great way to get invested in a book as well, especially if you think about first day, 100 pages. I am also reading something else that isn't sci-fi and fantasy, but so I'm just going to kind of throw it up into the air and show you guys, which is Ultra Processed People by Chris Van Tulken. I don't know if that's how you pronounce his surname. I am reading this because I want to read more nonfiction, and I'm really, really interested in nutrition and diets and stuff, because I really struggle with eating a lot of food that is very bad for me. I have recently switched over to a mostly plant-based diet. I feel like previously I was like, I don't know, like 80% plant-based, but some meals would have like cheese on top, or I wouldn't shy away from eating chocolate or having a whey protein shake, for example. But most of my meals were plant-based because my son is allergic to eggs and dairy. So he is plant-based by, not by choice, by biology. And we are vegetarian as a household. I've eaten meat. I haven't eaten meat since I was about 7, so 30 years. Eating meat, and I cook, so I don't know how to cook it. So it's not safe for me to cook meat for the family. So ego vis-a-vis, he's fully plant-based. I was 90% plant, 80% plant-based. And now I'm trying to cut out the few remaining things that I was eating that were not. And one of the ways that I want to do that is by reading some books that can educate me a little bit about nutrition and the food that we eat. And Ultra Processed People is one that I've genuinely been really interested in and have owned since the day it came out. And I was like, I'm going to finish reading this so that it can come off my shelf, because it is using a lot of shelf space. A Broken Binding book could sit where this book sits. Finally, you guys probably want to know what I'm going to read after I have read First Binding. Now, previously, I did tell you guys that I was going to read Leviathan Wakes, and then I didn't. So I'm going to do it now. Here's Leviathan Wakes. I was really flip-flopping between reading this or reading Authority by Jeff Vandermeer, I guess I could have read the next Sunita book. But I said I was going to read this earlier, so what I want to do is go back to that original thought and actually read this. So I really want to read this. Ross has just finished reading this, and Laura finished reading this, and Mare finished reading this fairly recently. So I think that maybe the four of us could get together and do a video. We'll see. I will try and read this quite quickly so that we can do that video. After I've read Leviathan Wakes, I need to go back to SPFBO books. I think I have at least one SPFBO book left to read. And I want to make sure. So currently, I think Surviving Westcliff is an absolutely fantastic. And I would be happy to put that forward as like, I think this should win, to Philip. But I feel like Soul Stealer, I also thought the opening was promising, so I do need to give Soul Stealer a decent chunk of reading to make sure that I prefer Surviving Westcliff. I want to read, I would say, like 25%, because I've read the first 50 pages, which is what Philip suggested we do, is read the first 50 pages of all the books, and only Surviving Westcliff and Soul Stealer stood out to me. But I think I want to get to 25%, because Soul Stealer is like 700 pages, so I want to get a decent chunk far. And also, people compare it to Game of Thrones and The Wheel of Time, and I love both of those series, so, you know. But I spent a lot of time talking not about Leviathan Wakes, which is the first book in The Expanse. I have actually watched the first like 4 or 5 episodes of the TV show, then decided that I wanted to stop and read the books first. That was many, many, many years ago, but I know a few things that happen in the first couple of episodes. I'm really excited to read this one based on the very diverse reactions that I have seen in the Discord about this. So, yeah, looking forward to reading this one. That is it for what I have been and will be reading. Up next, let's talk about videos that have gone up on the channel. So I put up 2 videos that I thought this week were a little bit out of my comfort zone, maybe. One was an author interview with JCM Byrne, the author of The Hybrid Helix, and one was my fantasy and sci-fi book quiz night. Both have underperformed for the channel. So if you haven't watched either of those, I'd be really grateful if you would watch them and then share them with friends. The JCM Byrne one is spoiler-free. Aside from some basic concept spoilers around his books, the Fantasy and Sci-Fi Books Quiz Night is obviously spoiler free. It is a 3-round trivia quiz on fantasy and sci-fi books, which has a fantasy round, a sci-fi round, and a picture round. So I really think that you guys will enjoy that video. It's a really good one, and I'm looking forward to hopefully doing more quizzes in the future. I was thinking about making it a weekly series, but next week I actually have too many videos to fill the week already, and I don't know about the week after. I would quite like to make a bit more progress on the Wandering In, maybe do a couple of 2-chapter weeks. So it may end up that the fantasy and sci-fi quiz becomes a monthly series. People have asked if I could get some other booktubers on to take part in the quiz at the live, as it were. If you would be interested in that, let me know, because I think that would be quite interesting. I had an idea about doing a like Family Feud style fantasy and sci-fi books quiz, but the issue there is that I think you just need a bigger audience than I have to get a decent survey together. Maybe I could just use the Reddit top 100 or something, but then you come across the fact that I would want to have multiple different categories, and that doesn't really work if you just use the Reddit top 100. Anyway, so give those videos some more love. That would be great. We're actually closing in on 800 subscribers right now, so while next week probably won't hit it, it's likely that the week after we may hit 800 subscribers. That's really fucking cool. If you subscribed, thanks so much for doing that. Next week, I owe you guys a Lord of Chaos review, which will be on, which might come out on Monday. The only caveat to that is Matt and I are doing our spoiler discussion next week. So if I do that, then there's going to be 2 Wheel of Time videos next week. So I don't know how on board everyone is about 2 Wheel of Time videos. I've also already filmed the Artemis review. So why don't everyone drop in the comments and let me know which review you'd prefer to see. So would you prefer to see the Andy Weir Artemis review, where I'm probably going to be quite outspoken, or the Book 6 of the Wheel of Time Lord of Chaos review? Book 7 is coming in August. I will read that in August. I will probably try and catch up at some point and read 2 Wheel of Times in a month. I'm almost tempted to try and read 2 books back to back, even though I never do 2 fantasies back to back. I am tempted to try, especially I feel like I've heard books 8 and 9 are like slog territory, but then someone else said that, so I'm looking up because I've recently bought all of the Wheel of Time books, so I now have the whole set. I feel like someone said book 10 is the worst, which is it Knife of Dream? No, Crossroads of Twilight. I feel like someone said book 10 was the worst, but books 8 and 9 are both quite thin, so it might be a good idea to try and do 8 and 9 in a single month. So maybe in September. Well, September is self-pub September. I want to do self-pub books that month. I will still do a Wheel of Time, but I want to do self-pub. Yeah, this is me planning YouTube content live with you on the channel. Let me know which books you think would be fun to read back to back, if you are a Wheel of Time stan. Sorry for the saying stan, I'm too old to be doing that. The other thing is that's everything. So yeah, next week will be probably month end stuff, because July is about to end. And then we won't be doing an August TBR, because this summer is Mood Read Summer, as you guys know. If you want a bit of a flavour of what I'm planning on probably reading, it's gonna be Soul Stealer, One Wheel of Time book, Leviathan Wakes, Authority, probably a Sun Eater, I don't know when the next Hybrid Helix book is out. That'll obviously probably I'll read in September if it's out by then. And of course, I do have Red Rising sequel trilogy to get to. So that is a series of sci-fi books that I haven't touched. I've also got a Star Trek book that I kind of want to read. So, yeah. Oh, and I've got Wool by Hugh Howey. I said I would read that. My buddy Kurt has just finished reading that, and he said, oh, I saw you mention it on your channel. Are you going to read it? And I really should. So maybe we'll read Wool by Hugh Howey in August. Not maybe we'll read it ever. We will read it. Thanks so much for watching today's episode. I did see Deadpool and Wolverine yesterday, but I think I might, having seen some other reviews, be extremely outspoken in thinking that film was just okay, with some jokes that I found to be pretty reprehensible and that I didn't really think were okay. Like a very kind of edgelord humour that I felt like most of the jokes avoid that and are really good and funny. And then some of them are just like out and out gay jokes, which doesn't really make sense to me. I've already started wrapping up the video, so I don't know why I'm talking about Deadpool and Wolverine. Thanks so much for watching. If you've liked this video, give it a like. If you would like to chat to me about anything we've discussed, tell me what you've been reading this week. Answer my questions I've answered in this one. So tell me whether you want the Artemis review or the Lord of Chaos review, and tell me which Wheel of Time books that I should read back to back if I want to do that. And subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Every little subscription helps. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great weekend, and I'll speak to you on Monday.